are packed. I'm ready. Look at me, wild, free, and pretending I'm not just another spoiled little prick with a lack of appreciation for how convenient our lives are these days. This is sweet California, where I deprive myself of all gadgets to live like it was the 60s again and to cook glorious desserts with very little on the road to God knows where. I get lost a lot. Today, I'm traveling with my trailer trying to find organic bananas for my next dessert. Pacific Ocean on my left, I think I'm getting close to the ranch. I'm going to Ventura to find an ingredient that is near and dear to all Brazilians. Yes, we have bananas in Brazil, but California does too. I'm here, and this is beautiful. Today, I parked my trailer at Punta Gorda Ranch, where organic bananas are produced by a charming guy called Andy. And I'm gonna use them to make us Belgian waffles with Foster sauce. Footprint is what we call the carbon footprint of imported food. It refers to the carbon released into the environment to produce the food we eat. And here in California, it's no different. The bananas eaten here come from far away. Venezuela, Chile, Colombia, and there's nothing sustainable about that. When we import food, we contribute to a series of actions that are harmful to the environment. Every time we import a product, we leave a bigger footprint. But not Andy. He's better than us. Since 2016, he's been producing bananas right here in Santa Monica. Eating just one kind of banana, that lame, tasteless kind, you should know that they have a surprisingly repertoire. Mysore, which is very resistant and takes a while to go bad. Orinoco, great for cooking. Cavendish, that not so special banana found everywhere. And my favorite, Wharf Brazilian, also known in Brazil as apple banana. So delicious. Imagine if an apple had made love to a banana and they had a child together. That's it. And I just assassinated this child.
This is what I just did to your tree.
Yeah, I know, you butchered it.
Good job, right? Like a professional?
Yeah.
The question that I've been willing to ask you all day long is, how did you get Brazilian kind of bananas?
I inherited them. So there was a gentleman about 20 years ago who was growing bananas here close by, in La Conchita. When my wife and I bought this farm, he asked if I'd be interested in buying them, and so he traded with people all over the world.
Why aren't more people producing bananas in the United States?
It's difficult in our climate to produce bananas. Even on this farm, there's only a couple of different spots where they're actually very productive.
Banana is like one of the most consumed fruits in the whole world. How much carbon dioxide you think you're saving from just like planting bananas here in California?
You know, it probably saves a lot because they're not being shipped from Costa Rica or El Salvador, or Nicaragua, or Panama.
Yeah. Can you hold this?
Sure.
Pretend you picked this beautiful bunch of bananas, but I did.
Okay, over my shoulder?
Yes, beautiful. Still confused about footprint? Let me explain my way. Footprint is the impact, or footprint, that people make on the environment to be able to produce food commercially. This lemon you found at your local grocery store was produced in India, so the footprint is the sum of the water, fuel, and energy used for cultivation and transportation to get to you. Footprint makes a huge harmful impact on the environment, so don't be a Godzilla and take good care of Mother Nature. When I buy bananas at Punta Gorda Ranch, I know that my product has a face. The face of Andy Schiffer. And with my patronage, he's able to buy a John Lennon-style sunglasses to protect his retina while he harvests bananas. Support your local farmer.
You can smile.
Oh, I can smile now? Yeah. Okay, all right, here we go.
I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back.
I've just cleansed my energy here with my incense, and everything's ready for me to make waffles with banana Foster sauce. Bananas, such a democratic fruit, so cheap. And in the 60s, we don't use any fancy appliance. We don't even need a waffle maker. An old-fashioned sandwich grill does the trick perfectly. Yes, you can substitute electricity for creativity. Cling! That was me winking. We're gonna start making Liège waffles, which is similar to a bread dough. In a bowl, add dry yeast, sugar, and lukewarm water and milk. Let it rest for 5 minutes, and the yeast is gonna get activated because it's a living organism. Then you can add egg and vanilla extract, followed by salt and flour. Mix it until a dough comes together, and then you can start kneading it. You can totally freestyle here. As long as you're stretching the dough and bringing it together, you are kneading just right. After 8 minutes approximately, it should look smooth and beautiful. Now we can add butter. Cold butter has to be added piece by piece. We have to knead it until it's fully incorporated before we add the next piece. Do it with patience and love, and before you even notice, all the butter is going to be incorporated and this dough is going to be beautiful and shiny. This process is developing the gluten much needed for our bread. The beginning is going to be sticky, but don't add flour, just knead it. Knead it! Knead it! That's eventually going to turn out just fine. Oh my gosh, that was horrible. My dough is ready, beautiful and silky. This is the texture. At this final stage, your dough should be as sticky as the back of a Post-it, which means not very sticky. This is a great tip for beginners. Add the dough to a bowl and cover it with a dishcloth. Let it rest for 2 hours. Deflate it and let it rest overnight in your fridge. Congrats, you've just made a viennoiserie, a type of dough enriched with butter that benefits a lot from a long rest in the fridge. The cold temperature keeps the dough from rising, so it develops flavor without fermenting. So now, both the dough and I are going to lay down and rest for the night, because tomorrow I'll have Liège waffle for breakfast. Good night.
Strange when you're a stranger, faces look ugly when you're alone. Women seem wicked when you're unwanted. Streets are uneven.
The best thing about going to sleep is that it's a time machine to breakfast. But I still have to prepare my Foster sauce. Ah, food cooked outdoors has this unique taste of insects. Into a pan, add brown sugar, salt, cinnamon, vanilla extract, and butter. Cook it over low heat until it caramelizes. Now, time for monkey's favorite fruit, bananas.
When you're strange, faces come out of the rain. When you're strange.
Choose a banana that's not so soft and slice it in a 45 degree angle. This way it feels like there's more bananas in the sauce. Add the bananas to the caramel and swirl the pan like a professional chef. Add rum and set it on fire to flambe so the alcohol can evaporate.
Fire!
Not that much fire, less fire. And my Foster sauce is ready and beautiful. Add a generous amount of pearl sugar to the dough. It makes all the difference. Cut the dough in 4 pieces and bring one by one to the sandwich grill, stretching it all the way to the corners. 4 minutes on each side over medium heat, and the waffles are ready and caramelized. This was my MacGyver moment.
I told you we don't need anything fancy to be a fancy baker. Look what I just made for us.
Ooh, waffles.
Liège waffle. Not just waffles.
Wow, look at that. I've never had a Liège waffle.
No? It's the best. And this is the Foster sauce made with your bananas. Smell this. Ooh. Can I put some rum in it?
Mm.
Why not? I mean, it's 8 a.m. Yeah. Rum. That seems right. You're supposed to laugh when I say bad jokes.
Oh, okay.
I'm joking. Beautiful.
Mm.
Wait, don't eat before me.
I'm not gonna eat, I'm gonna help you.
All right, let's go for it. Let's see if it's good.
That's very good.
So do you cook?
I do. I like doing more meat and spices in the breakfast.
So you're the stereotype of a man in a kitchen.
I am.
You deal with the meat.
The meat.
I'm glad your socks are matching my pajamas. Because yesterday, your shirt was matching my beret.
We're on the same wavelength here.
Beautiful.
Very good, thank you.
I brought something for you.
Mm.
From the last farm I visited.
Dates?
Yeah.
Wow.
Organic dates from Indio.
Indio.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Fantastic.
You don't have to eat them. You can eat later. Or you can eat now.
No, I want.
You want one? Okay.
No, I don't want one.
Yeah, don't eat it.
Okay, all right.
I'm gonna leave you. I'm gonna go for a swim. To wake up, it might be a good idea.
It'll wake you up.
Thank you. So many times I played around. I tell you now,
they don't mean a thing. Nature shows us every day that it is self-sufficient, and the less we interfere, the better it can do its thing. Now, I'm going to start my day with a sense of accomplishment for having shared this experience with Andy and you all. See you next time on Sweet California. So kiss me and smile for me.